Bangladesh is engulfed in street protests. Nothing new for the South Asian democracy and not something that Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina hasn't battled before. Universities are shut, mobile internet has been blocked, and protesters have set a TV station on fire. At the time of filing this report, 39 people have lost their lives. All of this is due to a quota system for government jobs in Bangladesh. What triggered the protests? Who gets quota for government jobs? And why are the students angry? What has been the government's response? This is Quick Take, your quick guide. I'm Smita Prakash. Protests erupted in June after the High Court reinstated a controversial quota system for government jobs. It reversed a 2018 decision by Sheikh Hasina's government to abolish it. This quota reserved 30% of jobs for the families of 1971 freedom fighters and has sparked similar student protests in the past. The Supreme Court temporarily halted the High Court's decision after the government appealed, scheduling a hearing for August 7th. But tensions soared when Hasina refused to meet the students' demands, citing the ongoing court proceedings. And then Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina termed the protesters as razakars, a deeply offensive term for those accused of collaborating with Pakistan during the 1971 war. In protest, the students started chanting slogans, "Who are you? Who am I? Razakar, razakar." The Bangladesh quota system. The quota system started soon after independence, that is in 1972, and has changed many times since then. By 2018, 56% of government jobs were reserved under different quotas. Under this system, 44% of first and second class government jobs are merit-based. Let's break down the 56% reservation and who falls under it. 30% for children and grandchildren of freedom fighters, 10% for women, 10% for Zilla quota for backward districts, 5% for ethnic minorities, 1% for people with physical disabilities. Students are now demanding the removal of all these quotas except for those for ethnic minorities and the disabled. This means they're demanding the removal of 50% of the reservation out of 56%.
কিভাবে সরকার এটা বলতে পারে যে রাজনৈতিকীকরণ করা হচ্ছে যেখানে প্রথম থেকেই আমরা বলছি যে আমরা সাধারণ শিক্ষার্থী আমরা চাচ্ছি যে একটা দেশে কিভাবে এটা তো একটা ন্যূনতম কমন সেন্সের ব্যাপার যে একটা দেশের 100% এর মধ্যে 56% কখনো কোটা থাকতে পারে না কখনো থাকতে পারে না কোনো সুস্থ একটা দেশে সুস্থ সমাজ ব্যবস্থায় কখনো 56% কোটা এটা মেনে নেওয়ার মতো না
What sparked the violence? The protests turned violent this week following clashes between thousands of anti-quota demonstrators and members of the Bangladesh Chhatra League, the student wing of PM Hasina's Awami League party. Protesting students alleged that Chhatra League supporters attacked them, hurling stones from buildings aimed at their heads. Police fired rubber bullets and threw sound grenades and tear gas to scatter protesters, who also blocked railway tracks and major roads. What did PM Hasina say? These protests are the first major challenge to Hasina's government since she secured her fourth consecutive term in January. Remember, the elections were boycotted by the main opposition, which called them unfair and unfree. She condemned the violence and urged patience until the Supreme Court gives its verdict. Law Minister Anisul Haq said that the government was ready to talk to the protesters, but the protesters declined, saying that discussions and open fire don't go hand in hand. What next for Bangladesh? Experts say the unrest in Dhaka is also due to stagnant job growth in the private sector, making public sector jobs with their regular wage hikes and privileges highly attractive. In Bangladesh, nearly 32 million young people are out of work or out of the education sector from a population of 170 million. The economy, once among the world's fastest growing, is now stagnant. Inflation is at 10% and dollar reserves are shrinking. For now, the streets of Bangladesh remain in turmoil. The Supreme Court's decision is awaited.